Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of Friday First Cut series. I am Nidhi Manchanda, a certified financial planner and head of training and development at Financial Hospital. As all of you are aware that last date to file your ITR for financial year 19-20 is 31st December 2020. And therefore, in this video, we have come up with a topic which is tax benefit on HRA and home loan. Are you staying on rent or have you purchased your own house? In both the cases, you get the tax benefit. Yes, you heard it right. You get the tax benefit irrespective whether you are staying in a rented apartment or you have purchased your own house. Now, in order to understand this tax benefit, we will discuss in detail. And let us first start with understanding the tax benefit when you are staying on rent. In order to get this benefit, you should fulfill two basic conditions. The first condition is that you should be staying on rent. And second important condition is that you should be receiving salary, and HRA should be one of the components in your salary structure. Now, if I tell you in very simple words, just check your salary slip and check whether you have an HRA component in it. If you have an HRA component, you can very well use this exemption benefit. If you satisfy these two conditions, then you can very well take the HRA exemption benefit. Now, the next question you must be having in your mind is, what is the amount of benefit that we get in this exemption? For the amount, we need to see a very simple calculation. Now, in this calculation, we need to check three different amounts. The first amount is the actual HRA received. Yes. And this is the amount which you can easily check from your salary slip. So just check your salary slip and see what is the HRA amount that you are getting. So that's the first amount, actual HRA received. The second amount is the rent paid minus 10% of salary. Yes, rent paid means whatever rent you are paying in the entire financial year minus 10% of your salary. So this will give you the second amount. Third amount is 50% of salary or 40% of salary. Now, when 50% and when 40%? 50% you have to consider if you are staying in a metro city, and 40% you have to consider if you are staying in a non-metro city. So this will give you the third amount, which is 50 or 40% of salary. Also, please note that when I'm saying the word salary, it means basic plus dearness allowance, not your entire salary. Just these two components you'll have to consider while doing this calculation. Now, when you have these three amounts in place, what you need to do is you have to check which amount is the lowest of these three. Lower of these three amounts is exempted from HRA, which means you can deduct this amount from your salary and you have to pay tax only on the remaining part. In order to claim this exemption, you have to submit rent receipts or rent agreement or both to your employer. But don't worry if you forgot to do so. You can still claim this exemption while filing your returns before 31st December 2020. This was all about HRA exemption benefit. Now let us see what benefit you get if you own a house. The government gives you this benefit only if you have taken a home loan. When you pay EMI, you pay a part of principal and a part of interest, and you get benefit for both. Yes, as per IT Act, you get benefit for both principal as well as interest. Now let us see what happens with principal. The amount of principal that you pay in the entire year is eligible for ATC deduction, and the maximum benefit that you can take under this ATC deduction is 1,50,000. On the other hand, if you talk about interest part, the entire amount of interest that you pay in a financial year is also eligible for deduction under section 24. And the maximum benefit that you can take under this section in a financial year is 2 lakh rupees. Also, please note that the house could either be occupied by you, or it is vacant, or you have given it on rent. In either of these three cases, you can take this benefit. I would like to give you a pro tip here that whenever you take a home loan, always take it jointly with your spouse as co-owners. Now, what will happen with this? both of you can take the benefit of 2 lakhs for the interest paid individually. Now that you have understood the benefit on HRA as well as the home loan, I would like to take up 2 frequently asked questions. Question number 1, what if I stay on rent but I am not salaried? Now in this case, you cannot claim HRA exemption because you are not receiving HRA in the first place itself. Yes. So what should you do? You can still get the similar tax benefit under section 18GG. So if you are self-employed or if you are receiving salary but HRA component is not there, you can claim the similar kind of a benefit under section 18GG. Question number 2 is, can I claim HRA exemption as well as home loan deduction at the same time? Now, the answer to this question is not a direct yes or no. It depends from situation to situation. So in some cases, yes, you can claim both. And in some cases, you will not be able to claim both. It differs from case to case. For any further query, feel free to get in touch with one of our tax experts who can help you plan your taxes as well as file your ITR before 31st December 2020. Before we end this video, on behalf of Financial Hospital, I would like to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year.